mansion, a condo, a cabin. I sleep in my Phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern. I ring your Saturn. I your madam, she get and I shake the ladder. I make her take her, then gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight get at them. I'm on a all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when they came in Islands. Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I innovative, I demonstrated this, played it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss your lady, then kiss the baby. Get situated, get keys off table and leave her. I really made it, get it made. Won't wrestle, cause I spatula all you action figures.
Tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls, they say, yeah.
I'm doing this for the L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told you did like a shell. I want a Ferrari in yellow, just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got my boss in the penitentiary. I got a that hangs several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley.
Thank you very much, Larry. You are looking live at the Georgia Dome here in downtown Atlanta. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Green Bay Packers and the Atlanta Falcons. On the return, the old reliable Devin Hester, the veteran. And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. First and 10, it's Ryan. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. He's got a man complete. And all the way down to the 35. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. For the first time with Devontae Freeman. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Freeman again. And some room to maneuver. Devontae Freeman, 33 yards, and the Falcons have taken the early lead.
Throughout the game, we're going to track so many different statistics, but one is becoming increasingly in vogue, explosive runs, runs of 20 yards or more, and we just saw one right there to open this game.
Now we'll see how the other team responds, because when you get a play like that against you this early in the game, you got to feel like your back's against the wall a little bit.
Yeah, the pressure now increases on you because your first thought is we have to answer right now.
Auspicious start here kicking wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by the former Cal Bear, Aaron Rodgers.
I remember meeting him when he was playing at Cal, and I remember walking away thinking, instead of having Rodgers stitched on the back of his jersey, it should just say confidence, because that's how he felt about his own abilities and his ability to elevate a team.
The first carry now, this is Lacy. He takes this for 3 to the 29. Six yards here to go for the offense on second down. They run it again with Lacy. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down.
Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a 3rd and 10. Throwing is Rodgers on 3rd down. And Adams has it. Good play. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
On 1st and 10, here's Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
319! 319!
Now a first down carry. It's Lacy. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about 3 down to the 38. On the tackle that time, Tyson Jackson. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Now Rodgers throwing on 2nd down. Oh, he was hit at the line of scrimmage and intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Collins. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, 2nd down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Rolling to his right. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and they're going to have a 3rd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now Ryan. He's going to air one out. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And a tough ask here. Here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. They'll run for it. It's Freeman. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And that will force a turnover on downs. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Dance class, anyone? Did you see the steps between the quarterback and the running back?
You need for a good counter.
You have to have it because you're setting up your blocking. There's a timing element as well, but they have to marry up their steps. Otherwise, that timing gets thrown out the window.
Timing was great.
That's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Off the play fake to Lacy. Here's Rodgers. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Second down, sacked by the defense. What type of pressure will they bring here on third? We'll see. On third and long, it's Rodgers finding time. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Jonathan Babineau in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up fourth and long.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
So on fourth down, the Packers turn to their punter, Tim Maste, to kick it away. Back deep for Atlanta, Devin Hester. They'll try and keep this away from Hester as this is going toward the sideline. Looking to build off that momentum.
They went into lockdown mode, didn't they? And what I loved about it is when someone goes for it on fourth down on their own side of the field.
Gutsy.
Not only gutsy, defenses take that as a sign of disrespect. And when they're able to shut them down and put it back in their face, they feel really good about it.
And got his man complete. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 89 yards. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. He's tough to contain as it is, but in man coverage with a pretty deep pass downfield, really tough to contain.
And it's so difficult because every play you've got to consider, he might try and run past you. So your goal as a defensive back is to give him plenty of cushion, meaning lots of space between you and him. If he wants to catch the short stuff, come up and secure the tackle, hit him a bunch during the game, and try and keep him in front. If you turn your head for a second, if your concentration wanes,
bye-bye.
He just takes off and goes. And I think that's what we just saw there.
And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown. For the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Rodgers to throw on 2nd down. And Cook has it left side. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
They'll come out in the pistol. On 2nd down, here's Rodgers. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Adrian Claiborne in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to make it 4th down.
That's certainly playing down a distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Turn Hester. What a spin. Ooh, with a juke. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
Good coverage there. An even 50-yard punt leads to a return of 5. And the Falcons will get it 1st and 10 from deep in their own territory. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right in your playbook, one play drive's exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
And a nice spin into some open field.
Whoa.
It still won't go down. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
That's why defense coordinators always preach 11 guys to the ball. Because sometimes you have a missed tackle, but if you have a swarm of guys around, less room for them to roam even after the first missed tackle. In this case, tackle is missed, plenty of open field to get after that.
Thank you.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. This is Freeman on first and 10. He juked him. And some space here. A big run there by Freeman. 43 yards. And Freeman, not sure if he was a surprise exactly, but he sure took the NFL by storm.
But when you talk with his team, they'll tell you they saw this coming. They knew he had the talent. They were just ready to turn him loose on a full-time basis, and he took full advantage of it.
And now one of the most electrifying runners in the game today. And now a first down following that long gain. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. Flush to his right, and his throw here is incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver, and now it's second down.
There are a good number of coaches at any time they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver, and on that play, it was batted down.
Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. Eluding the pressure right. This will be caught at about the 3. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Falcons will extend their lead. That's a heck of a start to this one for him here in the first quarter.
Two receiving touchdowns. Just getting the game underway, essentially. I mean, there's a long way to go. If I'm on defense, I've got to figure out how to slow this guy down. Because when one guy shreds your team, that's demoralizing. Make him spread it around at least. But right now, he's showing no signs of slowing down.
He missed one earlier, remember, but this time, he gets it to go. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now the Packers get set to go. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive.
The field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
They go play action here on first down. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Rashid Hageman. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's line, your left tackle. Maybe your highest-paid offensive lineman to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a 3rd-and-long situation coming up.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window. They've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. That one good for 14 yards. And it'll be 4th down.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And this will get inside the 20 and be touchdown just outside of the 15-yard line. So out comes, and it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
and they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, lead runners, anything that you have possible to get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle, and incomplete. Crisis averted, almost picked. Instead, second down.
I know exactly why I tried to throw the ball to Julio Jones there. He's never considered covered. He's either too fast or too strong. You always try and get it to him.
Especially on those deep passes. They'll roll him out right. And this one complete to Levine Toilolo. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Here's Ryan. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. They get 39 yards out of that one. And the Falcons are going to get a first. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
And he's got the hookup here, complete. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket, doesn't matter if they go left or right, the defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos back there, and receivers come open. Great discipline on that play. They didn't let that happen and held it to no gain.
Levine Toilolo, the tight end, is intended target, and it's third down.
In this situation, it's really tough to figure out how to defend because they have plenty of room to still take deep shots at the end zone as they just did there. Yet at the same time, you've got to be ready for the short throw. In this case, when you see the cue that they're going for the end zone, retreat and make sure you have a way to play forward back towards the receiver and have a chance to bat the ball away as they did there.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. Oh, the spin. That one good for 12 yards. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
This offense really put themselves in a tough spot on first and second down, needing long yardage to try and pick up a first down. And they ended up getting a great run. Explosive, picked up nice yardage. You don't expect to be in this situation on fourth down. But guess what? It all started with what happened on first and second down. Really put them behind the eight ball.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And that's caught by Tammy. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Jacob Tammy. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Falcons will add on to their lead.
How about that, partner? A little razzle-dazzle. Fake field goal that turns into a pass and a touchdown. Fooled everyone, including us.
Here's Bryant for the extra point. And that stretches the lead to 27. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told and a 9-yard run on the end of it. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. Set to return, this is Jeff Janis. Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3-and-out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's-